Welcome to another impactful, life-changing message from Apostle Deborah Bell, filled with the revelation of the Word and a demonstration of God's power.
See the fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God.
We have to be a people where it's time to take the dummies out of our mouths. It's time now. You guys are going to probably say, don't tell me I've got a dummy in my mouth, okay? You know what I'm saying. Paul put it another way. He said, listen, there's some that are on spiritual milk. And it's time for us to move from spiritual milk onto solids. What does solids mean? It's the maturity of the Christian. It's coming to a place where no longer do we have to continually be egged on by the pastor, egged on by someone else for our faith to increase. But we have a prayer life that is so strong that we begin to be egged on by the things of the Spirit. And when we come into the house of the Lord, that's just a double bonus. But we start to see with the eyes of the Spirit when we're off the dummy, when we're off the milk. So what does the enemy do? The first thing the enemy will do to new believers is he will try and stop the flow of the milk in your life. He'll stop you coming to the house of the Lord. He'll put you, set you back and put you into a place of the flesh so that you don't even feel like coming to the house of the Lord. But I'm telling you this morning, the Lord wants to ignite a fire in your hearts. God wants to reinstill and reestablish the connections. Taking the pacifier out means that consistency is returning. Consistency in your faith. Consistency. While you're going through the struggle, will you be sad? Yes, it's difficult. Don't hide it. You come in here and you be who you are. Don't hide it. But let God take hold of the wheel. Let God take hold of what's going on in your life. If you want to say, I'm a Christian, and you stand here today because you believe in the supernatural God that you serve, then I'm calling you to take the pacifier out this morning and to stand and say, listen, God, just forgive me that I haven't just counted on your supernatural power and love and presence in my life, that I've hidden from it, that I've walked from it, that I've tried everything but that. And that I come back to your house this morning to say, Lord, I want that fire to be rekindled in my heart. We cannot expect God to do things for us if we go off course in other directions. We can't expect for the pastor to lay hands on us and the Spirit to impart to us, listen, blessing is going to come to your house and this and that's going to happen to you. And then we go, thank you, Lord, I'll take all of that. And off I go out of the house of the Lord. I don't come back for a couple of weeks. And then I expect all of those things to happen. But I'm not being consistent in my faith and in my walk, and therefore I've gone off course. How can the blessing flow if the presence over there and you're over there? The present and the presence is over there and you're over there because you've gone in that direction and the Lord said, go this way. But you haven't been able to hear the voice of the Lord because your head has been so busy with the noise of the problem, with the noise of the struggle, with the whirlwind of the dilemma in your mind, with the double-mindedness that's come from a spirit of doubt that set itself into you instead of a spirit of faith that should emanate from you. We've got to take what God's word says, not what the devil is saying. And he's scooping you up. And this week's scoop is to say, listen, you're never going to make it. And so we buy into it. Now we like living in fear, so we start making the wrong decisions. What's God's scoop? God's scoop is, get into my word. It will remind you of my power. It will bring revelation. Are you on the road to Damascus? Are you on the road and the path and in alignment with exactly where God wants you to be? Or are you measuring yourself by what's comfortable for you, of how much you're prepared to let go of yourself, of how much you're prepared to give? Have you come to a place, church, where you've said, God, whatever it takes, I will do. Whatever you want from me, I will do. Not limiting God or saying to God, you know what? You know what, God? I'm going to give you this much. And that's enough, don't you think? Controlling how much you give to God. Limiting what you allow God to do in your life. You want God to do all these things for you. You want all the blessings to flow. You want the Spirit. You want the presence. But what are we prepared to do for the Lord? What are we? God gives it freely. But God says, freely you have received. Now freely give. And that's not just about money. But the devil gets our minds into the place of the flesh and says, listen, you work so hard. You can't possibly do more than that. Something has to break in us this morning. Something has to break. Something has to shift for us to get the fire back. Something has to shift in us. But God wants to see that our hearts are willing, ready. When you come into the presence of the house of the Lord and you hear the word and you experience the presence again and you recognize, listen, what's going on? And the word of God is spoken and we start seeing things. We don't always see those things. And so our hearts close up. And before we know it, that despondency is there. And we don't realize that it affects our whole life. And instead of being vulnerable, we close up. And that's what hardens our heart towards God and brings us back into the flesh. And if you can recognize that process, and when it's happening, and it can happen as quick as 24 hours, you can leave this building today, something can happen tomorrow, and if you haven't got the pacifier out of your mouth, you cannot prophesy. Remember what I've said this morning. Take the pacifier out and prophesy so that you don't fall into those positions. And if you do, get some people around you to pray for you that you trust and walk the journey with you so you're not alone, that you don't fall into the abyss or disappear as a statistic or give up hope and still say, I just love my God still, you know, but I don't feel like going to church. Is not everything. We're so clever with our minds at justifying. But it's time for us to be so on fire for the Lord that we want to be here as often as we can in every possible moment we can, because we understand we're hungry for more. And we're not listening to the flesh, amen? So friends, do whatever it takes to make that happen in your life. If we're talking about the Damascus journey this morning, I want to tell you that it's a journey of encounters. It's a journey of glory. It's a journey of the supernatural. It's a journey of destiny. It's a journey of promise.
My heart's on fire. My heart's on fire. So I'm singing. Ring down. Ring down.
Thank you for joining us. Come back next week for another life-transforming message from Apostle Deborah Bell. Ring down.